Hey guys, I'm Amarot and today we will continue our work on maps generated by the tool I showed you in the previous tutorial. And our objective will be to take a map which we got in just a few clicks and apply some layer effects from Photoshop to it within a couple of minutes, in case we want to get something less plain looking than this. First of all, I will show you the settings I used on this map. You don't necessarily have to copy them all, but I highlighted some I really recommend to make things easier. First, we will export the map as a PNG file and then open it in Photoshop. Now we will make use of the Wand tool. Tolerance seems to work the best around 5, and make sure you have anti-alias on and contiguous off. We can proceed by clicking on the topmost part of the town, and those are going to be the fortifications. A single click with the Wand tool should select just the walls and associated lines. After making a selection, you can use the lasso tool with the subtract mode on and deselect anything you don't want in the layer you are going to be working on. In this case, I am going to deselect this small monument because I don't want it to look like a wall. Continue by right-clicking and clicking on layer via copy and name your layer appropriately. Since I want the inner keep to look a little bit different from the outer walls, I will also select the keep in our new layer with the lasso tool, and this time I will use layer via cut option. The next thing should be buildings, so let's make another wand selection and another layer. Now we can proceed with the road fence and the fields and with the water as well. The last thing missing is the grass. We will simply make a new empty layer, call it BG for background, and fill it with the paint bucket tool. Now we have the city map split into individual layers and we can apply different layer effects to them. I could walk you through the making of those layer effects in detail, but I already showcased how to make them in the previous videos, so I will rather show you what I would normally do. I've got this city template project file already, and this is effectively just a collection of layers with different effects I already prepared earlier. So now I can just keep reusing them, just with a few tweaks here and there, as the particular map requires. We can just right-click a template layer, click on Copy Layer Styles, go to our current map, right-click on the target layer, and click on Paste Layer Style. Now all the effects are here and we can just adjust them if necessary and add some more or remove some. For the keep, I am using bevel effect with texture applied to it. Stroke and inner glow effects can help you make more defined lines, and drop shadow to add to the 3D effect. Pattern overlay is, at least in my style, pretty much a must and one of the main reasons why I am doing this. I will now do the same with all the remaining layers. The wall layer is going to be effectively the same like the keep layer, just with less prominent bevel and drop shadow effects. The buildings layer is also pretty much the same, just with a different pattern and way stronger bevel effect. I am also applying some color and I can easily just change it to anything else. In this case, I will adjust the bevel and color a little bit to make it look better. The fence layer is a combination of bevel, wooden pattern, and drop shadow, a rather minimalistic one. The fields layer is just a simple pattern effect. We will go back to the fields in just a moment. The water layer can get more complex than this and definitely deserves a video of its own. But for now, I am using a simple pattern and inner glow, and additionally, I am also using a bevel effect, but this time a downward outer bevel effect, which is being applied to the surrounding underlying layers, not to the water layer itself. And finally, the background layer, which is just going to be a simple pattern effect. Obviously, the fields are rather off, and you can either paint them by hand using a random spray brush, or you can go to the filter menu, blur, and I like to use the Gaussian blur. Roughly 10 pixels should do. And in case the fields are not very well visible, you can copy the fields layer several times over to make them more opaque. As a side note, you can also edit any of the already existing layers add new towers, add new buildings, add new walls, whatever you want to do. Right now, we can pretty much call this a day, but there are all kinds of additional things we can place on this map. We can, for example, add some more vegetation to make a forest, a garden, or a city park. We can also add additional textures on the background. This will make it look less repetitive and more interesting. I pretty much always use at least two background textures. In the same way, I would also add some roads. For labels, I prefer to make a group and apply effects to the group, so as I am adding labels, icons and such, the same effect is applied to all of them. Most often, I am using a combination of stroke and outer glow to highlight the labels and inner glow to give them color. The cool thing about the inner glow is that you can add jitter to it, which gives the labels an extra character. We could go on and on, but those are the important basics and I showed how I use them in one of my previous MapLabs videos. In the future, we may possibly get a little bit more into detail with the individual components which make up a town map. So, I hope this was useful to you, and as always guys, happy mapping!